What's going down, y'all? Welcome to another video, and today we're gonna do a transformation haircut on my brother. Boy, it'll be looking nappy. So we're gonna start off with our Andes 5 guard. We're gonna chop everything off from top. Been a minute that I haven't recorded, but we're back and we're gonna try to upload as much as we can. Took a little time off, you know, even though I haven't been doing this for a while, but yeah, we're back though, and better quality, better haircuts, better tutorials. Comment whatever you want to see. Vlogs should be coming in soon. Got a story to tell why I stopped vlogging for a while. So once we do the 5 guard, you know, I went over it multiple times, we're going to get our 3 guard and this using the Oster Fast Feed open, and then we're going to take off all the bulk from the side. Once we take off the bulk from the side with the 3 guard open, we're going to get our Oster Fast Feed open. We're gonna do clipper over comb. You pretty much clip over comb, you try to get the hairs that are sticking out, take off a little bit more bulk from the top. After that, we're gonna start our first guideline with the Andes TL liner. We're gonna bald out the first guideline. So I kind of changed a little bit my steps after the T liner. I'm gonna grab my Andes shaver and we're gonna do the baldness right under the first guideline. Then we're gonna grab our zero guard. We're gonna zero guard close and do our first guideline, like an inch. Use your zero guard, we're gonna go halfway and then I'm open. It's pretty much like trigger plane, so you can fade it. After that, like, my usual steps, we're going to get our one guard close, then halfway then open, then two guard close, halfway then open, and then work your way down too. So it's going to be two guard open, then halfway then close, one guard open, halfway then close, zero guard open, halfway then close. After we fit it to the top, we're gonna do our Oster fast feed still. No guard close. We're gonna flick it the bottom line. And then we're gonna go halfway, flick the next line, and then open. Consider flicking an initial fade all the way to the top. And remember, I'm gonna go back in detail. I'm gonna use my zero guard again, my one guard, my two guard, whatever it takes so I can just flick in. You can see the nice blend. This is a simple method to fade, really easy. Just follow the steps and make sure you flick right, and you know, go back to your work and see any little details you gotta work on. So yeah, this transformation is really crazy. He had long hair for a while, he hasn't gotten a haircut, and you know, had to bless him. I'm gonna do a little design too on the side, a little part design after the haircut. So as you can see, I'm going back over my work, just if I see any little dark spots, any details that I gotta go back over and do, go ahead and do so, you know. Take your time if you're barely learning how to cut hair, so you could see any little lines or any details you gotta work back and do it. Make sure you go back and do it. It's really on details, so your hair could come out really, you know, nice and fresh. So the other side of the haircut is pretty much the same thing. I'm not about to go over it again. It's the same steps as the other side. The first side we did, this is 3-guard, open, you know, then bald it, and then we start our guidelines and fade up. Don't be scared of fading. Make sure you go back and you detail your work. Hey, but make sure you subscribe to the channel, follow me on Instagram, and just know that we're gonna just drop some lit shit on my channel soon. Shit, it's been a minute. I haven't even done a voiceover and I feel a little rusty, but hey, we gotta get back to it and grind harder this time. 2019 should be a better year. Make sure you subscribe though, remember, turn on the notifications. So on our lineup section, I always start from the middle and work my way to the sides and the other side, and make sure it's lined up straight and even. You don't want your clients to have a crooked lineup or not as squared on the tips of the lineup. Make sure it's really sharp and pointy. Just make sure the lineup is really square though, for sure. Another thing, make it as natural as possible. You don't want to push back anyone's lineup at all. No one's. That's the worst. Don't push up a lineup so you could think your haircut's so crispy and pops up more. No. A haircut will pop up a lot more if the lineup is crispy, natural. So here we're just gonna do a little design inside, a little part for the fade. It's pretty much like a line, as you can see how I'm doing it. Make sure first you do the first little sketch guideline, and after that go back over and make it a little thicker from thick to like thin, you know what I mean? So you could like the haircut could pop up way more in the design as well. You can see the design. Hey, drop a comment though. Let me know if you guys like the designs or not, or if you guys want to see anything else, drop a comment, subscribe to the channel, and share it. Make sure you share it, tag me on it. So right here I'm razoring the design and the lineup. Make sure you put any like shaving gel. You don't want to do it dry, and make sure you stretch the skin and you shave carefully. Hopefully you guys enjoy. Like, comment, subscribe, share the video. Let me know what you guys think about the haircut, the transformation. Thank you. y'all for watching. See you guys in the next one. Peace.